is Davi with the super gossipy faux buzz.
So, I'm Davi, and I know, like, every celebrity, like, all of them. I'm serious. You should see my squad.
Are you the close source?
I am the close source in every magazine that you ever read. So if you read, like, so what is it, like, In Touch or, like, OK Magazine, I've been quoted in The Enquirer, like, 5 times. It's not a big deal, but it's a big deal.
I feel so honored that we have The Source in studio.
Okay.
The Source.
Got it.
Every magazine, because I know everyone, and I'm a blogger, but I've also been described as, like, a pathological liar, and I'm like, oh, my God, they think I'm logical, and, like, a social ladder climber, and I'm like, yes, I am fit. I look like I'm at the gym all the time. Thank you. And so, yeah, quoted in In Touch, Enquirer. Oh, Tiger Beat is one of my favorites. They're hilarious. Those guys are funny and star, and I'm always the source. When you see the source, yeah, that's me. And I'm super duper close with all these famous people. Like, my squad basically consists of Jennifer Lopez, Jennifer Aniston, Jennifer Garner, Jennifer Lawrence, and even Jennifer Love Hewitt, which none of the other Jens like, but I still invite her because I'm such a nice person. And also Mindy Kaling. So, and, like, I met them, like, in random places, like jet skiing in the Ozarks and Pilates classes. And, like, I met Mindy Kaling shopping at Ross. She hates it when I tell people that, but it's not a big deal. It's no big deal.
They have really good deals.
Yeah. Right. And, like, Jennifer Lopez actually stole my microphone when I was doing a sick Shania Twain solo.
What?
And I straight up punched her right in the boob. And I guess she respected that because she, like, understood how someone could not contain themselves during Shania Twain. I totally get it, too. So I'm like, honey, I get it. It's not a big deal. So first off, Kristen,
yes,
you lied.
Mm-mm.
To,
no,
like,
I didn't.
Everyone. Your
no.
pants are totally on fire. Charlize and Brad, that's a total charade.
Yes.
Do you see what I did there?
Liar.
Yes.
Instead of charade, it's, like, based off their names.
You're super clever.
But Jennifer Aniston, though, like, seriously, that amazing skin, it's not just a vino. It's from all the sun she's getting on her honeymoon in Italy with Brad Pitt right now.
Brad Pitt and Jennifer Aniston are back together.
They're back
again.
Together.
Oh, the source has the scoop.
Oh.
You didn't know this? They're making up for all that lost time on a romantic getaway. And they had a no-frills backyard commitment ceremony. They pledged their love in front of their parents and their close friends like me. And then Brad's kids. They didn't tell the kids until the last minute because they wanted to surprise them. And the kids were like, oh my God, Jen, welcome to the family. It was the cutest. You know Brad and Angie's kids, all of it's like Shiloh, Maniac, Zahara, Paxil, or is that the medicine I take? I can't remember. And then there's like Knox and Junebug. I'm going to be honest and just say, like, I don't care about anyone's kids' names and I don't learn them and I shouldn't be expected to. Selena Gomez, she's doing so great, you guys. Like, she's so great. Oh, I like to call her Little Miss New Kidney, you know, because she, like, I tried to give her mine because I'm such a good friend. It's not a big deal.
You guys are super tight.
I'm such a good friend. I tried to give her my kidney, but she was like, nah, because I was like, it's got kidney stones, girl. I'm just going to be honest. I don't want you sounding like a rain stick when you're out there dancing around on stage. And she was like, you right. And I was like, word. It's not a big deal. But she's so over Bieber. And she doesn't care about his silly marriage to Haley Balda girl or what is her name?
Baldwin.
I don't even care.
Haley
I don't
Baldwin.
Even care.
Bald loser.
She literally was like, I don't care. I want a real man, not one that I can fit his whole butt in one hand. And then she called him a tiny butt weirdo. That was her words. It's not mine.
Of course, because you're the source.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tiny butt weirdo.
I mean, we have a faux buzz with the source of every entertainment story we've ever done on the show.
I mean, and like, yeah, I met Selena. I don't even remember. I don't even remember what it was. Like, I think she was Pilates classes. Or no. No, she actually saved my life. She saved my life.
You
but I don't want to talk. I don't want to talk about it right now.
Can you
it's
please?
Not a big deal.
No, you brought it up. Tell
no,
us.
It's not a big deal. I can't talk about it. She'll get so mad. Anyways, in Malibu. So you know how Malibu is like known for its picturesque beaches and its multi-million-dollar celebrity homes. Like it's so amazing. Have you ever been to Malibu, Bo?
Nope.
No.
Uh-uh.
Kristen, have you ever been to Malibu?
Once, long time ago.
Okay, it's like really pricey, and all the mannequins there have like tig old bitties,
uh-huh.
And I feel really insecure. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get it.
Like, why do the mannequins have to look like that?
I feel that way with the mannequins in the Nike store. But they diesel. You see them abs? It's crazy.
It is. I think they, like, modeled those after yours, though. For being
of course
honest.
They did.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And did they even ask you for permission?
Nope.
Rude.
Want my money.
Oh, my God. Anyways, so, yeah, Malibu and its beaches. You guys, there's a murder in Malibu.
What?
Uh-oh. There is a Malibu murder mystery. People are being murdered.
How have we not seen this in the news?
I don't know. So, like, I mean, I've been talking about it in the news. Obviously, these crimes have everyone who lives nearby on pins and needles. See where I said it?
Yeah.
See where I said it?
Oh, I see the source.
Pins and needles. They called me In Touch Insider in this one. But, yeah, I came up with that pins and needles thing. I think I invented that. Now, so that's me. I'm the insider. And all these A-listers are freaking out. Like understandably so. Like, they've lived there. And, like, all the Kardashians, Katie Holmes, Jessica Simpson, Will and Jada, and their kids, Jack Cole and Fern. And what is so funny?
Pretty sure it's Jaden and Willow.
Yeah. Oh, I got the wrong tree. It's not Jack Cole?
No.
Uh-uh. Oh. I don't think so.
Anyways, so, and then Robert Downey Jr. Oh, my God, he's so hot. I want to be Mrs. Downey Jr. so bad.
How bad?
So bad.
Got it.
And I'm taking the junior. It's Mrs. Downey Jr. Anyways, so all the celebrities are, like, fearing for their life. But if I'm being honest, I just can't wait for the Netflix special and then, like, the Clue-inspired board game that is going to come out, because I really think it's one of the Kardashians with a candlestick, because come on, girl. And now I'm going to talk about movies this weekend, because there's, like, one I'm really excited about and then some crap. So movies this weekend, there's Serenity. Spoiler alert, Matthew McKindalame takes his shirt off again. And then there's Glass with that fine ass, ooh, Bruce Willis.
Hey.
Bruce Willis?
Yeah.
Bruce Willis.
I love him. And then The Upside, yeah. So the downside of that, Kevin Hart's in it. He's so small, it's like watching subtitles. Like, I don't want to work right now. And then that guy that used to sell meth is in it, too. I'm excited.
Well, thank you very much, Davi. The source.
Thank you.
Of every entertainment story ever written in every tabloid rag.
Yeah.
That was...
That's me.
We appreciate the scoop.
I'm the source.
Hey.
The Bert Show.